In this tutorial, we're going to learn how to create this 3D sunken lettering effect, where you have inner drop shadows to make it look like the lettering outlines are raised. We'll also cover how to create this shaded extrusion that comes off your word, and a drop shadow against the canvas. You can download the exact color palette I'm using, as well as the monoline brush I'm going to use for my outlines from my website, so check that out if you want to follow along with those tools. So we'll start off with just this outline sketch of the phrase "nice work." I already completed the first word, so I'm going to turn that on as a reference while we walk through the second word together. To get started, create a new layer above your outlines and then grab white from your palette. I'm going to use my square monoline brush to get a perfectly even outline width along the edges of my letters. One trick I like to use here is to extend my lines past the corners. That way I can go back and erase the parts I don't need, which leaves me with a really crisp corner at the end. So I'm just following my sketch outlines, extending each line past the edge, and holding my pencil down on my iPad screen at the end so that Procreate snaps each of these into a perfectly straight line. Now to get that perfect outline with the crisp corners, reduce the opacity of this layer so you can see the sketch lines underneath. Then take an eraser and you're just going to chop off those extra bits that extended out too far. This will give you really clean and precise edges at each of your corners. Repeat that process for the rest of the letters in your word. As you're creating shapes, remember that in Procreate, if you hold your pencil down on the screen after drawing a shape like a circle or a curve, it'll smooth it out for you automatically. If you touch your finger to the screen while you're doing that too, it'll snap it to a perfect shape, like a perfectly round circle. Now again, go back through your word when you're done and erase the edges that extended past your letter so you can get those crisp outline corners. Done with your outlines, you can turn the opacity back up, and you may want to name your layer in Procreate to help keep things straight. We're done with that sketch layer, so you can turn that off. And now you may see some imperfections in your outlines where you didn't erase perfectly, and now's the time to go back and fix those. You want to make sure you are completely happy with your outlines before we move on, because we're going to be duplicating this outline layer and using it to create the other pieces of our word. Once you're happy with your outlines, we'll create the fill layer. You're going to duplicate the outline layer by swiping to the left and hitting Duplicate in your Layers menu. Then swipe with two fingers to the right to turn on Alpha Lock. You can rename your layer here to Fill to keep things organized. And now change the color. Select the medium teal, go back to your layer, tap on your layer to bring up the menu, and hit Fill Layer. Then swipe with two fingers to the right again to turn off Alpha Lock, which will allow you to drag in the color and fill in your letters. The next thing we're going to add is the inner shadow that will give your word that sunken effect. Duplicate your outline layer again, label it Inner Shadow, and repeat the process of activating Alpha Lock and filling your layer to change the color to dark teal. Swipe off Alpha Lock again and use the Move tool, which is the cursor icon at the top, and move this layer so that it's slightly offset from your outlines. Here I'm going to move it down and to the left, but you can adjust this based on where your imaginary light source is coming from in your illustration. Now we need to get rid of that part that's extending outside of your outlines. To do this, go to your layer menu, tap your fill layer, and hit select. Now hit invert at the bottom of your screen, go back to your layer menu, tap your inner shadow layer, and then hit clear. That deletes anything outside of your fill layer from that inner shadow layer. With that cleaned up, grab your favorite drawing brush and go through and connect the dark teal to meet the corner of your white outlines anywhere where they don't. This is what will give the illusion that your outlines are raised, as if there's a little wall going around the edge of your letters. A simple effect that makes your letters look like they're sinking into your canvas a little bit. You could stop here and just keep that sunken effect, or you can add an extrusion to your letters as well for even more dimension. To add an extrusion, you're going to duplicate your fill layer and change its color to the lighter pink. Remember, to do that, you're going to swipe with two fingers to the right to turn on Alpha Lock, then select your new color, go back to your layer, and hit fill layer. Swipe with two fingers to the right again to turn Alpha Lock off. Now drag that layer down into the side to create your extrusion. Then you're gonna do basically the same thing we did with the inner shading, which is connect the corners of your extrusion to the corners of your outlines to connect and fill the extrusion so it looks like one continuous block extending from your letters. Certain layers or lower the opacity on them to make it easier to see where to connect some of the corners. Extrusion added, it's time to add a drop shadow for your whole 3D word against your canvas. To do this, duplicate your fill layer and duplicate your extrusion layer. Then drag them so that they're together in your layers menu and merge them together. Now use the Alpha Lock technique to change the color to the darkest pink in your palette. And drag the layer diagonally away from your word. Lower the opacity to make it look like a shadow. Here I'm going down to about 17%. And again, you're going to connect the corners, but only the corners of your pink extrusion. Because if you imagine this to be a 3D object sitting on that canvas, these are the only corners that would be touching that canvas. So notice I'm not going to connect any corners at the top to my white outlines because those are raised up in space. They're not actually touching the canvas, and so they wouldn't be connected to this shadow. The final touch is to add some shading and texture. Create a new layer above your extrusion layer. Tap on it to bring up the menu and select Clipping Mask. Grab the medium pink color from your palette and select a brush you like to use for shading. I'm using the Gouache Shader 06 from a Retro Supply Co. pack here. And then shade the areas of your extrusion depending on where your light source is. For this word, I created that drop shadow in the last step, extending down and to the left, which would mean that my light is coming from the upper right. So I'm imagining which surfaces of my extrusion would not have that light on them, and that's where I'm going to shade them in darker on this clipping mask. For rounded surfaces, try fading out the shading as you go around the edge closer to where the light's hitting for a more realistic effect. One last thing I like to do is add some texture to the surface of my word, just to make everything feel a little more cohesive, rather than just having a flat surface color. For this, create a new layer above your fill layer, make it a clipping mask, rename it, and then grab the lightest teal color from your palette. I'm still using my gouache brush, and I'm just going to paint some texture over the surface of my word. This is a subtle effect, but it'll help tie your piece together since we have textured shading on the extrusion as well. Once you're happy with your texture, you're all done. You've got a 3D word with a shaded extrusion, a drop shadow, and a sunken letter effect. If you like this tutorial, be sure to like and subscribe, and let me know in the comments what questions you have, and what tutorials you'd like to see next. Thanks!